Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. I'd like to welcome back my colleague Martin Williams, who was away for the past 9 months on a fellowship at Stanford. He'll now be based in San Francisco, and we'll have him on the program soon. We'll start this week with big news from Microsoft, their new tablet called Surface. It debuted at an event in Los Angeles on Monday and has effectively given Apple a 2-year head start on the tablet market, which will make it difficult for Microsoft to gain ground. The Surface will run both Windows RT and Windows 8. It has a 10.6-inch screen and comes with a 3mm thick, pressure-sensitive keyboard that doubles as a cover. Microsoft didn't provide launch dates or pricing, but said it would be competitive with other ARM-based tablets and would be out around the time of the launch of Windows 8. In his latest attempt to evade the law, WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange has requested political asylum from the government of Ecuador. The move came about a week after the UK Supreme Court refused to reopen his case. Assange supporters fear that from Sweden, he could be transferred to the US to face charges under the country's Espionage Act, and if convicted, could be put to death. Ecuador is evaluating the request. The U.S. is back on top as home of the world's fastest computer. The U.S. Department of Energy's Sequoia supercomputer has 1.6 million cores and can perform more than 16 petaflops. The U.S. lost its throne to China in November 2010. In 2011, Japan took the top spot. On the top 500 list, the U.S. houses 252 of the computers, followed by Asia with 121 and Europe with 106. Larry Ellison, the billionaire CEO of Oracle, will soon have a new bachelor pad, an entire Hawaiian island. He's reached an agreement to buy 98% of Lanai, one of Hawaii's 8 main islands. He still needs approval from the state, after which he'll command 88,000 acres of what the state calls Hawaii's most enticing island. It's home to 3,200 people, and Ellison anticipates, quote, making substantial investments in Lanai and is looking forward to partnering with the people of Lanai to chart the island's future. Researchers have built a prototype display designed to compensate for vision problems so users don't need to wear eyeglasses. This display is only 1 centimeter square, but packs a resolution of 1224 by 800 pixels at 1800 pixels per inch. In comparison, Apple's Retina display on its iPhone 4S is 326 pixels per square inch. The display could compensate for near and far sightedness, astigmatism, and cataracts. One researcher thinks that after the 3D hype is over, TV manufacturers will be looking for new features, and this could be one of them. Amazon's App Store will open this summer in the UK, Germany, France, Italy, and Spain. The App Store, which competes with Google Play, was launched in the US last year. For users with Android-based tablets and smartphones, it provides an alternative source for applications from a trusted brand. Japanese toy maker Bandai showed several new products that use augmented reality, where virtual characters are projected onto real-life backgrounds. Here's a card-based game that allows players to scan in characters when they buy cards. Robots that have been scanned in can then be used to battle against other players in a turn-based combat game. The cards, which cost about $5 a pack, will be sold in Japan as well as Singapore, Hong Kong, and Taiwan. Bandai also showed a new set of figurines that perform virtual actions when viewed through a mobile app. They're made to be sold from coin-based toy dispensers, which are popular in Japan with collectors. The figures have their names and special visual codes in their bases, which the software uses to identify them. To encourage collectors, the company says that combining multiple figurines will unlock different graphics. Instead of turning knobs and pressing buttons, Ford hopes you'll use your voice to control many of the features inside its cars. My Ford Touch and Sync now gives drivers voice control of just about every dashboard system. For example, manually inputting an address while driving is dangerous, so Ford's turned that over to voice control.
In Massachusetts, say the street address including the city.
1 Wayside Road, Burlington.
When ready, press the voice button and then say set as destination, or say change something.
With satellite radio, a driver could tell Sync to tune to a certain sports game and Sync would find the station. Or it could request Boston traffic and the system would do the same. On the new Ford Escape, drivers that have their hands full with groceries or luggage can wave their leg under the bumper, and as long as the key's in their pocket, the liftgate will open. While most of the voice processing is done on board, one of Ford's voice engineers sees a benefit as cars become more connected.
As cars do get more connected, we do believe there will be off-board voice recognition because the power of the cloud is really strong. But additionally, you know, our onboard processors are getting more capable. So you'll see more capability in the system onboard, and you'll see us leveraging the cloud.
To outfit the new Ford Escape with the latest technology, drivers will have to pay about $2,000, and prices vary by model and market. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. To find out what's coming up on every week's show, be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. And mark your calendars. In 2 weeks, on July 5th, we'll have a special summer edition of World Tech Update, where I'll be on location at where else but the beach. As we head out this week, we'll leave you with some shots of the set for the opening ceremony of the Olympics. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next week.